Hi, this is Fee. Thank you for joining me on my channel today. I'm at the point of putting a second coat of epoxy resin or art resin onto my diamond paintings. I set this up with these guys upside down. My apologies here, but at least you'll see that I'm on this side. First things I've done is I've got a plastic sheet down. I do have these are actually already leveled, so I've got my spirit level on both of those. They are on shooter cups, but to help with leveling, instead of I've used blue tack to help level. Now this is like the fourth time I've poured resin, and I thought what I might try and do with these guys is work out whether the volume and weight is even, because I would prefer to measure by weight because then I've got a more accurate reading. So I'm going to tackle this one on the left of my cub first. When I completed these guys, I did sand back and recoat the side with paint. The plan is to actually have these where it's actually curved over, not where it's domed on top, where it's actually curved over, and I want the black to be glossy. So fingers crossed we get that. Okay. Just I'll get you to hold there for a second, and what I'm going to do is just rearrange this camera, maybe you'll get a bit better view. And there we go, a sec. Hopefully this is a little bit better view for you. And I'm going to try not to crinkle this paper. Hold on a second. Should tape it down. Okay, so a 30 by 40 according to Art Resin. So I'm using these guys, Art Resin. They are non-toxic. No VOCs. So this can be used in an enclosed room without needing respiration. And before I go any further, I'm putting gloves on. I wear two lots of gloves. I've discovered that I use one, which is the long cuff, which then allows me to be able to keep my jewellery on, because I can pull it up over my jewellery, and I like to keep my watch on. My jewellery doesn't come off. I keep my watch on because I need that for a timer. So I have the long cuff. Bracelet's now covered. And then I go with the normal gloves. Now these are nitrile gloves. I went to a hardware store to get a packet of these. But when I got home, I actually discovered that the guards that I had in my kitchen, under my kitchen sink, were exactly the same. Now the reason why I'm wearing two sets of gloves is because once I get grotty with these, I can take this off. I've still got my hands protected underneath. What it also means is working with gloves, I get sweaty fingers. So when I need to change my gloves out, all I need to do is take this one off and put fresh ones on. Okay, so I suppose I should say here goes nothing. I have two measuring cups. So 30 by 40 requires 190 mil. Okay, that's a bit special. 190 mil to do a 30 by 40. And that's 190 mil of each. I will pour these separately. What I do is, you'll see I've actually got A and B written all over these jugs. Because what it means is all I need to do when I finish, I rinse these out and wipe them down, and they're all good to be used again, so long as I only use the correct stuff. if I put B into this, that's it, I've got to throw this cup out. But, so, I'm going to do the A, and bottle's just about empty. That was one of the things that delayed me with doing my next, getting this one, doing my second coat on this, because I had to order more. And what I am doing at the moment, now I'm going to tear that down. What I plan to do is actually see whether 190 mils weighs exactly the same in the resin as well as the hardener. Because, okay, I'm just gonna let that sit there and drip for a bit. And I did get a bigger bottle because I initially bought the art resin to see how I went with it. Just realizing you're not seeing my hands. Bear with me while I lift this up. Hopefully that's better. You might, I don't know if you ever see it, but I'm barefooted. I hate wearing shoes. Okay, so yeah, this is, the art resin is pretty expensive. So when you work with it, you try not to waste any of it. But I think I'm not going to get any more out of that. I might try and get more out of that when I do my next, when I do my next one. So, okay, I'll put the lid on that. That's A, I'll just put that aside there. Okay, so what we're after is 190, oops, oh, let's get that. And these guys, because it's a chemical, you do need to get it exact, 50, 75, 80, okay, whoops. Okay, that's what I needed to see. Grams. Okay. So that's actually 195 of a. I had actually spilt some of the A onto my scale, so I had to quickly grab paper towels because I forgot to grab them. So 211.3 grams of the A, and now to measure out the B. And what I should have done is actually just left that upside down. I'll come back. Whoops. Do with that. I'm gonna do it next time. So. Now let's see how we go. What you will see though is stirring sticks. I've discovered I'm going through a lot of stirring sticks. There's a good reason for that, is you don't want to mix your sticks because it is, yet again, it's trying to get that perfect blend. Oops. And okay. Right. So the A was that. The B is actually 189.7. So they are not same weight wise. And here we go. You're going to see me swear because I've just put too much. Have two options. I can add more, or I can only add. Can't even take. I've got to add to the. So what I've just done then, I've ended up with too much hardener in comparison to resin. So put the, and just so you know, those red stoppers, put them back in when you finish with them. So what I need to do is just touch up with the A, just to come on out. It's not going to come out for me. Okay. So one of the things I wanted to do was actually get there and go, okay, it's exactly the same in weight for each. And now I know it isn't. Gosh. Gotta love wearing gloves. Now I need to just put another little bit more in to even that up. Okay. Right. So now that's A and B. What I do need to do is get some big, big clear cups, not the red ones that I've got here. Put these scales away. So A and B. The B is, so yet again, I'm keeping my paddles separately. The B is the hardener. One thing I have been doing a lot of, like everybody else, Googling, doing a lot of YouTube searches. One of the things I've found that has been said most common or noticeably is that if you put the hardener in first, because if you put the hardener in first, it's better for mixing it or something or other. So I have been putting the hardener in first, and I'm trying to scrape down as much as possible out of this, because yet again, trying to get that precise measurement. So, because I'm going to be doing a second one, I'm keeping these as they are. I will be doing a mix with a separate paddle pop, but in goes the resin. And it's really funny, for all the different resins that I've been seeing mixed, most of them, I think about 80 to 90% of them, actually turn around and say 3 minute mix time. That's coming from consumers and also the companies that produce the resin. So these guys are resin, 3 minute mix time. And I'm gonna try and see if I can get my watch to do what I got it to do the other day. Hey Siri. Set timer, 3 minutes.
Okay, 3 minutes and counting.
Okay, so it's just a case of stirring it, and there is actually, it does look stringy. Oh, there's my dog. I'm actually in one of the back bedrooms with the door shut and the air conditioner on. So with stirring these, you've got to make sure you're scraping up from the sides and really mixing it. And I'm not sure if you can see the, it's like a stringy look to it. Okay, I can't hold that down on the table. I'm thinking that I might only need to put half of this because I've done one pour already. So what I'll do is I'll pour half of this on to the put half of this on to this one, and then we'll go from there. So mixing, 1.5 minutes to go. And you can see when it's mixed. So if you mix it for 3 minutes and it's still looking stringy, and until you're actually mixing it, I didn't understand what they meant. So while you're mixing it, if it's still stringy, continue to mix for longer. For you, those of you that bake cakes, this will be a breeze. those that beat, well, I mean, I bake, but those that use hand beaters and whisks, the whipping's not so bad. What do we got? It's a minute to go still. Scraping it from the sides. Scraping it so I've got whatever's coating the paddle pot. Stirring stick. And do a good scrape around. Again. Gosh. I've seen some different ways for mixing this. I've been watching some where they're doing the bulk massive pours of resin, and you know, using the machines to do the mixing. And even with the machines, they're still mixing it for 3 minutes. So it must be that time side of things. Okay, are we there yet? Yep, okay, Siri, stop. There you go, my time is over. What I'm doing is just having a look at this. It's looking pretty good. Hang on, I need it close to me. So it no longer looks stringy. I can't see anywhere where it looks stringy. So what I plan to do is I'm going to pour one on the left, my cup, and see how he goes. So I'm going to use about half of this mix first. I'll put another half in there. And yes, I have a plastic coating, plastic tablecloth down as well underneath this paper. My first times I did this, I was in the garage, which was really good. However, what I did find that once you do these, you need them to sit for at least 24 hours. Sit for at least 24 hours. And then from there, it needs to sit another 72 at least. Okay, so. Get rid of that paddle pot. And I was going to use a spreader, but this just seemed like a bit of an overkill. This actually was with the, I don't know if you can see the sign on that, art resin. So it is actually from these guys. There is bubbles. These bubbles will come out, and this is self leveling. Okay, so I've got half of the mix. Grab a clean paddle pop. Okay. Whoops, I've just put that. That one that I've just mixed it in, that's got to go in the bin, so I won't be able to, can't use that again. Right, so spread this out. I'm initially spreading this out just to the edges. I do want this to go run over the edge, over the sides. But more about trying to get this at least to the edges. Whoops, there we go. I've started on the sides now. So what I want to do is make sure I've got it going over the drills. Okay. And I'm at the point of giving up on using a paddle pop stick and just going into it with my hands, because it's so much more fun with the hands. And you got more control with the hands. So here we go. I'll put that paddle pop in there. The set time for this is, you generally have half an hour, 45 minutes to be able to work with this. So what I'm doing is around the edges. I want the resin to go around the edges. So that cup's in the bin. This resin that's dropping from the side, I'm trying to try and put it back in. So this resin is self-leveling and the aim now is to make sure that my hands do not end up over top of my timber floors. I do have a big mat underneath me, but I just would rather err on the side of safety and caution. Okay, so we've got that all the way around, and there, so that's all the way around. Everything's coated. So this will self-level. What I'm just feeling for, because I know I've got raised bits here, I'm just making sure that they feel like they're going to be covered without any issue. I just want to make sure. Okay, so yeah, because I've already done one coat, I didn't need to do a second. What I'm doing now is running my finger along the underside. And I forgot to mention some of the other steps that I did. Underneath these, under here, is actually painter's tape. So painter's tape is there to protect. So when the drips, when it runs down, the drips will come underneath here. And once they're underneath the painter's tape, you can actually peel the painter's tape off, which then should peel those drips off. Okay, so I only did need to do the one mix. Yay! This is fun. I'm looking forward to when I start using the colours, when I start tinting the resin. Alrighty-o. And up. And up. It's like running with it's almost like using a really thick nail polish is probably the best way to describe it, and it's pretty cool. But yeah, I'm looking forward to working with tints. So pretty close to working on it with tints. Okay, but definitely there's a lot in there. I actually might scoop some of that up and pour it on your cubby. You can have a bit more. It's great at self-leveling. Once I've finished with that, there we go. That's that one, and that's everything. Right, now get this all the way up and making sure that those drills, this is the one where I think I'll have issues with. This is the Hey Diddle, was the one that I didn't trim down to size. So Cubby, I turned around and I trimmed him down by one row on the side, one row on the top. Whereas this one, I didn't trim down at all because I wanted to see how it went. I also, these, if you recall, these ones also had the, because I didn't have the canvas stretched tight enough these have actually dipped and bowed, so that it's just thicker in the center. But with that being done on the first coat, which is why I had to do two coats, on the first coat, because that happened on the first coat, it then means that that dip's already filled. Okay. So how are we going there? I don't think this one's going to come. This one come out okay, but I do believe these edges are not going to work right. I just love the feel of that. Okay. Just making sure that the edges are all the way around. There it is. Yep, so that's coated all the way around. Making sure that the corners are good. Oh no, I've just spotted a drill has come up off a cubby. Number five. Oh well, way too late now. Right, gloves off. So that's now got all the acrylic is in there. And these are clean gloves still. Okie dokie. What I am doing, I'm putting the gloves back on again now. I'm putting gloves back on. I'm going to try to. Doesn't help me a lot for your mouth. Okay. So now what I'm going to do now is I'm only putting the glove on one hand because the other hand I'm going to use a flamethrower. So the Yuki's hairdryer, I think a little fire lighter, fire torch, fire flame thing, or this dude here, the gas, and the other is heat guns. So what this does is pops the bubbles. Don't want to be too close to it, and you don't want to take too long with it. Okay, so I'm going to have issues with this edge. Straight out, I can see it. This edge is going to cause me no end of trouble. Because yet again, the drills haven't. But this is what these were. These were test pieces. So the drills, I've still got rough edges here. So definitely if you're doing a 30 by 40 like this on a frame, make sure you trim it down. My little cup here looks good. See if I can get some more resin on there. Not much has dripped over the sides. Not much has come over the sides. Pretty good. So just yet again, doing it again. Trying to bring any air bubbles to the surface. There's still some air bubbles here. So basically that is it. What I need to do is cover them. Run my finger along the edge here, try and get some drips off. Because although I've got the painter's tape there, it's still easier to actually get the resin off get the drips while it's wet. It's just a bit less you need to worry about. Okay, so just click through. I can't see any more bubbles popping. This one's not going to be any good by the look of it, but when I show you, you will understand what I'm getting at. This one is major learning curve. This one is a good learning curve. Okay, so that is the resin applied. Get rid of the gloves. I'll just wipe down a couple of things. That's rubbish. Those cups are good. Obviously, I've just done all that pouring. I want to make sure that everything in my area is clean, clear, because now what I need to do is cover and protect. I'm just making sure I've got room to put my boxes down. And what I do want to do, I know I'm going to end up, it's going to end up happening. All this resin in the middle. Just trying to try and clean it up, because when I put the boxes over to give a form of protection, hang on a sec, sorry. Okay, so when I put the boxes down to cover, I don't want them to. I don't necessarily want them to stick to there. The resin can stick to the paper towel. Just trying to do this carefully. I'd rather the resin stuck to the paper towel than the boxes that I'm using, because the boxes I'm using just a bit hard to get hold of. Okay, so okay, and first box, actually a fine box, this one from because of a fridge we had to purchase. Continue filming. So bear with me, and so I will see you very soon. Okay, so it's just been over 30 minutes, and just gonna put the one glove on. My partner has come and had a look at these already because he can't wait. I have got the blinds open, which is why you're seeing a lot of glare by the look of it, but I want left eye open so you can actually see the effects. So I poured, so this is where we're still experimental side of things for me. I did a mix up and went, oh no, it'll be plenty, I'll do one for half this one and half for that one, and done the pour, and my partner turned around and said, you have not put enough on. So what I've got to do is I've got to do another full pour, full batch just for one and a full batch for the other. So I'm not sure if you can see it. So what I do at this point is I come along, run my finger along here, I'll go through other things, run your finger along the edge to get any of the dripping down. It just makes it easier than having to worry about it when you worry about peeling it off. Okay, I'll do this side. So that's just taken off some of the drips off the side of it, and I'm going to move you, I'm going to stop this now and I'll continue on, bring you down to show you. Is the edges, you can see how I've got nice edges there, whoops, okay, yet here. You can actually still see the drills. You've got nice smoothness here for the drills here. So what we're wanting is to be like this all the way around. So you can see the glare and how it's not filled in. So what he said is just best way to do it is just redo another pour. Do another pour. Bring it into here. Not too bad of you to see. Gives that nice gloss there. Whereas if you look at this edge, see how that's. This is where I've been saying I should have cut it down smaller. But then yet again, at this angle, you can see the drills and then you see the smooth. So, whoops, around this angle. So this is where you really see the look at the sparkle coming off. That's just the sun on the resin. But you can see the edges. It's actually good where you can see the sparkle. You can see where it hasn't filled. So what I should have done is two lots of 190 for one and two lots of 190 for the other, which then should have worked perfectly. We do have some edge, I'm just trying to find it. See what you've got is the edge there, which is what I'm after. That's come up lovely. But this one is still, yeah. So, need to fill it up and have another go. So in another 2.5 hours, you can really see it there, but another 2.5 hours, I'll be back and putting another coat on. Okay, so I was going to come back and do a second coat on these, a third coat. However, my partner actually got involved and kind of semi-took over. So we turned around and put a second coat on, the third coat on. This one here, Hey Diddle Diddle, I've just completely written that off. That's now a flop, but I'll take you through that. Whereas my little cub, he has turned out quite nice. Still not 100% happy with that, but we'll deal with that. So, first of all, the one that is a flop. So what you can see, I've actually got to lift this. Excuse me while I do this. Off. Okay, so what I did when I put this down, I put the plastic shooter cups and I used the blue tack to a level. Okay, and now all I need to do is lift up the piece off the blue tack. The cups are still there, they're still stuck, but we're all good here. I'll show you is what's wrong with this one. So you can actually see, I'm just going to try and move the lamp so you can actually see what I'm talking about. You can still see the bubbles. You see how it hasn't sealed up properly. So I just didn't put enough on, plus the glue didn't hold this down, so it's lifted up. So the edges are quite shocking. However, the effect that I was looking for is actually on the edge of, I did get it on one edge. But that's how shiny they come when you put acrylic on there. But there is no sparkle that you normally get. So remembering this is a round drill. So normally you get a lot of sparkle on a round drill. That sparkle's gone. So if you're going to do this process to seal, I would turn around and actually put glitter in. So in the acrylic, and I'll do that next time. But put that one to the side, or just behind me. This is the one I'm looking forward to, which is the cup. So, yet again, I will lift this up. And we'll actually reposition this camera. Okay, so just reposition the camera so you can see this better. So, what we're looking at is, you can see how this is stuck down. What I'm going to do is lift up and up. So what I've got is the back, and down here you can see the shot glasses and the blue tack. So what that means is I'll lift all this up and that can actually go. However, instead of that, I'm actually going to do this so we can see what I've got. We're part of the setup. With part of the setup, I mentioned was the packing tape. Actually, hold on a second. I'm going to clean up underneath me, and we'll go.
Sure.
Mess is gone. You might hear some noise in the background. My other half is just on the other side of the wall behind you. He's talking very loud on his phone. Right. So what we've got is, it's got the third coat of resin on it, and I'm just going to see if I can get the light on it. You can actually see how smooth we've managed to get that edge. There's a couple bits where it's not quite smooth, but basically all the way around she's come up beautiful and smooth. See that gloss on there? Okay. So, steps from here is just very simply, I'm turning this over, and we've got the painter's tape. I didn't show this step, but I did say it was done. So the painter's tape is down, and it was, the way that's done is to stop all these drips from actually sticking to the back of the canvas. Generally, this is supposed to be done when it is wet or semi-set. However, semi-set was, I had to go to bed last night, so I couldn't do it. But the painter's tape, when you put it down the right way, should be able to lift it up, and it comes off. And you can see there the drips are on the painter's tape. Okay. And just work your way around, take that off. I will do another when I do my next one, which will be a square, and it won't be too far away because I've got it nearly ready to go. Just want to make sure I'm not getting underneath the canvas itself. Right. The next one I will go right from start to finish, now that I've got my head around how to do this process. A lot of it was trial and error, and as you can tell, one error and one where this will get mounted in my house. And So that's how easy painter's tape comes up. So that is, hang on, can I find it? I can't see it on my bench here. Just normal painter's tape at a hardware store. That's all it is. Whoops. Okay, so there you go. Here's an oops. I've just peeled that back and gone too far, not being cautious with it. What I will do is, just with the X-Acto knife, bit of super glue on that corner where I've just peeled it off. But there's Cubby. I will actually pick the camera up and give you a closer look at it. But he is gorgeous. I do like this effect. I think the next one I do though, well the next one I do is will be the squares as opposed to this being round. I'll take you from where to go and I will put some glitter inside one of the layers that I do on this. So hopefully you like it. Just hold on a sec and I'll zoom you around so you can get a better look. Okay, so for a better look, my lamps, I've got a heap of lamps here to try and give better light in here. So here you can see, actually the light's doing well to show you, but you can see I've got some dimples here. Because this is more of a first run trial, I wasn't too concerned, but I was also expecting it because it's not fully, you can see the drills just slightly sticking up. However, we come along here and they are actually, that's nice and smooth. So what I've got is a layer of resin right the way over. So I am really happy with this. This is just so smooth. And here we go. This is what I'm showing you. Here is where the drills are still up. If I cut this one row in from the left, one row from the left, one row from the right, one from the top, one from the bottom, I would have ended up with an edge like this one, where beautiful, smooth edge, as opposed to having this. Also, probably if I use better glue, I use the spray adhesive, won't use spray adhesive. So we'll come back and look at this one. Because this one didn't stick down properly, and I didn't end up wasting much more time on it, I just went, no, that's it, I'm not wasting any more effort. You can see how you can see the drills there. Yet here, it's beautiful and smooth. So that was just a really bad go. But this one was not cut at all. So this is a 30 by 40 on a 30 by 40 frame and not cut at all. Cubby, 30 by 40 frame, cut one row and cut one row. But I love him, he's gorgeous. And I will stand him upright. He's actually turned out quite nice. Okay. So yeah, so next thing we do is I'll do a square and I'll film where to go. And I won't have my other half jump in and take over. If he wants to jump in, you're going to get to hear him properly because I'm going to turn around and say we're filming while he's work doing it. Okay, so thank you for watching. I hope you like this as a good demonstration or half a demonstration of resin, working with resin. A little bit of information of what I've gone through and why this has happened. And when you look at it, this hasn't stuck down. This edge has not stuck down. So you can see, there we go, that's a perfect way. So the edge didn't stick down because it overlapped and because of the glue. Whereas, you know, the edge has stayed down. That's been the curve. So yeah, stay tuned for more resin work. One is resin with covering diamond paintings. The other is actually resin artwork. So that's yet to come. That's my next exciting adventure. So thank you for watching. Please like, share, subscribe and hit the bell. And that way you'll get notified of anything that I'm doing. And also, if you pop a comment, I will do my best to answer. Any questions you have, I'll try and deal with as best as I can, as best of my ability. Okay, and I'll catch you later. Bye.